Hello kids, today we would be doing an interesting lesson. I will show you some pictures. Lion, cheetah and an elephant. What are they called? Are they domestic animals or wild animals? Now, tell me, where do they stay? They stay in a zoo and in the forest. Let us learn about the forest and their wildlife. We will listen to a discussion between a teacher and a student.
Hello kids, today we will talk about forests.
What does forest mean?
The picture above is of a forest. Now tell me by looking at the picture, what is a forest?
We see tall trees.
Okay, you see, in the other picture, it is very dark, very less sunlight. We would learn about our forests and wildlife.
Will you teach us both?
A forest is a large area of land thickly covered with trees, bushes, etc. The trees and bushes grow on their own. This is called natural vegetation.
What are bushes?
Bushes are low plants with many branches that grow near the ground.
What is natural vegetation?
Natural vegetation refers to a plant community which has grown naturally without human aid and has been left undisturbed for a long time. This is termed as natural vegetation. There are different kinds of forests in different regions. It depends on the rainfall, temperature, and soil of that particular region. In India, we have different kinds of forests. We have five main groups of forests: evergreen forests, deciduous forests, coniferous forests, marshy forests or sundarbans, thorny forests. Evergreen forests. Forests that remain green throughout the year are called evergreen forests. They don't shed their leaves at any particular time of the year. These forests have tall, thick trees that the sun rays cannot pass through them. Trees like rosewood, mahogany, sandalwood, and bamboo grow here. Their wood is very hard. We can make furniture with rosewood. We use sandalwood in making agarbattis, soaps, perfumes, etc. These forests are found along the western ghats and in the northeastern parts of the country. Deciduous forests. In a deciduous forest, the trees shed their leaves every year. They grow in areas having hot and wet climate and where the rainfall is moderate. Such trees are teak, sal, shisham. The wood of these trees is good for making furniture. Coniferous forests. Vegetation composed primarily of cone-bearing, needle-leaved or scale-leaved evergreen trees found in regions of the world that have long winters and moderate to high annual precipitation. Coniferous forests. Precipitation means drizzle, rain, snow, etc. Thick coniferous forests are found in Himalayas and the Nilgiris. These forests are also called mountain forests. Trees like cheer or pine trees and deodar are found in these forests. Marshy forests. A typical wetland with plants which have less wood and which tends to be low growing is called marshy forest. They are found in the deltas of rivers, edges of lakes and streams. For example, in West Bengal, we have thick forests on the delta of the river Ganga. This marshy forest is called the Sundarbans because the kind of trees grow here are called Sundari. thorny forests. In regions with less than 70 centimeter rainfall, the natural vegetation consists of thorny trees and bushes type of vegetation, which is found in the northwestern part of India. Trees like babool, kikar, thohar, and kher are the main plant species. Trees are scattered and have long roots penetrating into the soil in order to get moisture. These plants have thick, fleshy, water-storing leaves or stems. These forests are found in Rajasthan, Punjab, central Maharashtra, east Karnataka, and Gujarat. Most of the plants in these regions are very medicinal. Advantages of forests. They help to cause rainfall. They give natural shelter to all the wildlife. They purify the air and thus protect the environment from pollution. They check the erosion of soil. They help prevent floods. They give us firewood to burn. They give fodder to the animals. They help to make the climate cool and pleasant. They give us timber for our furniture and buildings. They give us hardwood for making railway sleepers and coaches. They give us many herbs that can be used as medicines. They give us wood pulp to make paper. They give us such materials as resin, gum, honey, lac, rubber, tanning materials, etc. Forests make a beautiful sight and attract tourists from far and near. Conservation of forests. Forest is the second largest land use in India next to agriculture. They play an important role in the economy of a country. Forest is a growing, changing community made up of many different plants and animals that interact with each other in many ways. A country should have at least one third of its area under forests.
Unfortunately, in India, we don't even have one fourth of the land under forests. We have destroyed our forests thoughtlessly. It is our duty to make up for the damage done. We must stop cutting trees and conserve our forests. It is good that our government and our people have realized the importance and taken steps to protect our forests.
Van Mahotsav. This is celebrated every year in the beginning of the rainy season. A large number of trees are planted all over the country on this day. Under the Social Forestry Program, people are encouraged to plant trees along the roads, canals, and railway lines. A tree for every child is a program where every child is encouraged to plant a tree and take care of it. The Chipko movement has brought a great awakening to the people. In 1974, the villagers of the Alaknanda Valley started this novel movement. They would cling to the tree if anyone tried to cut it. Their slogan is, "If you cut one tree, plant at least one." This movement proved how important trees are. Therefore, we should treat forests well as our common treasure and generate public awareness. Kids, we too can help in conserving forests.
How can we do that?
We should plant at least one tree near our house and take care of it.
How do we get a plant?
You can go to any of the forestry department in the city and ask them. They will help you get one.
Hello kids, yesterday we learnt about our forests and their importance. Today we will be learning about wildlife.
Today we will be learning about wildlife.
That means we would learn about lions and tigers.
Yes, we would learn much more about it. How many of you have pets at home?
I have a dog, cat, lovebirds, rabbit and horse etc. Answers given. Domesticated animals.
Does anybody have a tiger as a pet?
No, teacher. Tigers live in forests.
Very good. So the animals which are kept as pets are called domestic animals. The animals that live in forests are called wild animals and live in a forest or jungle.
Forests also have wildlife.
Yes, today we will understand what is wildlife. Wildlife means animals and birds living in natural conditions in an undomesticated state.
What is undomesticated?
Undomesticated means any of various animals that have not been tamed or fit for a human environment.
How do wild animals live in a circus?
In a circus, the wild animals are tamed, trained and taught how to live with human beings and their environment. They are domesticated animals. They are trained by experts. In India, we find a large variety of wildlife. Forests in the northeast of India have in them elephants, rhinos, tiger and bears. The Sundarbans are the home of the famous Bengal tiger and white tigers. Lions are also found in the Gir forests of Gujarat. The deciduous forests are the home of leopards, tigers, bears, wild buffaloes and boars. In India, we have a large variety of fish and birds. Reptiles such as snakes, pythons and cobras are found all over India. Crocodiles and tortoises are found in most Indian rivers. In India, the cobra snake is found very largely. They are poisonous. If a man is bitten by a cobra, he will die if he doesn't get the aid immediately. The Indian community also worships it. He is the Nag Devta or the snake god. There are two types of snakes, poisonous and the non-poisonous snake. The poison of the snake is removed by the experts and is used as an antidote for snake bite.
What does an antidote mean?
A medicine given to counteract the poison. It will cure the bite. The non-poisonous snakes do not have poison. The other reptiles found in India are crocodiles. They are mostly water-bound reptiles found in most of the Indian rivers and canals. They live in water and sometimes come on the land to take the heat. When it becomes too hot, they go back to the water. They maintain a certain temperature to keep their body cool. That is why you will find the crocodile with its jaws on the surface of the water.
Wildlife is a valuable gift of nature. Birds and animals help to keep a balance between plants and living beings. Unfortunately, senseless hunting and killing has destroyed many beautiful and rare species of animals and birds. This has created a lot of natural calamities to occur and reoccur periodically. To avoid any natural calamity like floods, drought, earthquake, etc., our government has set a number of sanctuaries all over the country. Sanctuaries provide natural homes for all kinds of wildlife. No one is allowed to hunt or kill animals and birds in these sanctuaries. Some of these sanctuaries are Kaziranga in Assam, Gir Forest in Gujarat, Corbett Park in Uttarakhand, Periyar in Kerala, Ghana Bird Sanctuary in Rajasthan, Kanha Natural Park in Madhya Pradesh. Okay kids, have you understood clearly about our forests and wildlife? Now, let me wave goodbye to you. Hope you have enjoyed learning